have had cyclical wars or periods of unrest in Burundi and fights between the two major ethnic groups, the Hutus and the Tutsis. And it's very complex. That's how the conflict has been presented in the world. But in my opinion, it's more a political conflict than an ethnic problem. But nonetheless, it's an issue, and people are dying or were dying, you know, every day. Being a young mother and growing up in a country like that, I had been looking for ways to find a place where I would have a peaceful life, where I could raise a family, and where I could be allowed to dream about the future. When I left in 1996, it was the third time of leaving Burundi and being a refugee. As a grown-up woman, this was my decision that I didn't want to live in that kind of constant fear. So I left and went to West Africa for 2 years, and although I had a great job, it was, in my mind, it was still temporary. I was looking for a place where I could go and immigrate and start from fresh and have a future and give a future to my son. And I worked for an agency that worked with refugees, so which was kind of interesting or traumatizing to some extent, because I knew it could be me in the refugee camps that we visited. Looking for an opportunity to come here was like a relief. I had my son, but I also had three sisters and one brother, all younger than me. And they were all in school at that time, and the conflicts that we had in Burundi were interrupting education. They were also living in fears. My parents were not ready to leave, because they had been refugees before, or had lived in other countries before, but they were looking for ways, for opportunities for my brothers and sisters to go and live in a place where they would be educated and would have access to uninterrupted education, and also where they wouldn't have to fear for their lives. It was really hard. When we left Burundi, it's very difficult to explain. It's almost like making the decision that, you know, this is great, I like it, but there are so many things that I will not be able to live with, and if I live at all. So you leave everything that you know behind, everything that you cherish, your family, your friends, your memories, the smell, like, it's very difficult, you know, the colors of the country, you know, your belongings, your house, your everything, and you just, you know, close that door and go and start from scratch.